Breakthrough artificial intelligence turns text, photos, and even videos into 3D avatars. With RODIN from Microsoft, anyone can now create a super realistic 3D avatar from an image input or a simple text description. RODIN is a 3D generative model that uses diffusion models to automatically generate 3D digital avatars represented as neural radiance fields. A significant challenge in generating such avatars is that the memory and processing costs in 3 dimensions are prohibitive for producing the rich details required for high-quality avatars. To tackle this problem, artificial intelligence researchers from the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, together with Microsoft, have presented what they call the Rollout Diffusion Network, abbreviated as RODIN, which represents a neural radiance field as multiple 2D feature maps and rolls out these maps into a single 2D feature plane where 3D-aware diffusion is performed. The RODIN AI model provides much-needed computational efficiency while preserving the integrity of diffusion in three-dimensional space. Latent conditioning is also used to orchestrate feature generation for global coherence, leading to high-quality avatars and enabling their semantic editing with text. Finally, hierarchical synthesis is used to further enhance details. The 3D avatars generated by the model compare favorably with those produced by existing generative techniques. Even highly detailed avatars with realistic hairstyles and facial hair can be generated, and the model doesn't just generate 3D avatars from image or text, but also has the ability to edit those avatars with text prompts. Generative models are becoming the standard for many difficult tasks in computer science and currently provide the most promising methods for analyzing and synthesizing visual data, with examples being DALL-E 2 from OpenAI and Stable Diffusion from Stability AI, which are two well-known generative models for creating realistic and attractive images from complex text inputs. Their architectures are also based on diffusion models, which have shown great generative power for images and videos. There have been rapid advances in diffusion and generative modeling, leading to a revolution in 2D content creation. The idea is simple. If you can describe it, you can visualize it by allowing the model to create it. Generative models are capable of incredible things, and while 2D content has been a challenge for diffusion models, up until now, 3D content has posed more difficulty. As technology increasingly relies on digital avatars in movies, games, the metaverse, and the 3D industry, the ability for anyone to create a digital avatar can be very useful. This was the motivation behind the development of the RODIN Rollout Diffusion Network for avatar creation. How it works is that the model takes an image, random noise, or a text description of the desired avatar for input and then derives a latent vector to be used in the diffusion process, which involves several noise and denoise steps. First, random noise is added to the starting state or image and then denoised to produce a clearer image. The difference in this case is the 3D nature of the desired content. Next, the diffusion process proceeds as usual, but instead of targeting a 2D image, it generates the coarse geometry of the avatar, followed by a diffusion upsampler for detail synthesis. To increase efficiency, the artificial intelligence researchers utilized a triplane representation of a neural radiance field, which offers a much smaller memory footprint compared to voxel grids without sacrificing expressiveness or quality. But what if you could use a video for input to create an ultra-realistic avatar of not only a face, but an entire body too? To do this, Nvidia artificial intelligence researchers recently proposed RANA, a relightable and articulated neural avatar for the photorealistic synthesis of humans under any viewpoint, body pose, and lighting. A short video clip of the person is all that is needed to create the avatar, and no knowledge about the lighting environment is required. The AI researchers present a novel framework for modeling humans while separating their geometry, texture, and lighting environment from monocular RGB videos. To simplify this otherwise difficult task, they first estimate the coarse geometry and texture of the avatar using SMPL plus NI model fitting, and then learn an articulated neural representation for photorealistic image generation. How it works is that RANA first generates the normal and albedo maps of the person in any given target body pose, and then uses spherical harmonics lighting to generate the shaded image in the target lighting environment. The NVIDIA researchers also propose pre-training RANA using synthetic images and show that it leads to better separation between geometry and texture while also improving robustness to novel body poses. Separating the texture, geometry, and illumination information is necessary for relighting in different contexts, but is a challenging task when working with RGB footage. To overcome this, the researchers used a statistical human shape model to obtain coarse geometry and texture data from the training frames. Nvidia then used a convolutional neural network trained on artificial data to remove the shading information from the coarse texture. To capture person-specific characteristics for a new subject, a new set of neural features are learned, and, according to the research, it's possible to create an avatar for a new subject after just 15,000 training iterations. So far, RANA is the first technique that allows neural avatars to be both relatable and articulated. Articulated neural avatars that are similar to humans have various applications in telepresence, animation, and the production of visual content. These avatars need to be easy to create and animate in different poses and viewpoints, able to render photorealistic images, and simple to adjust lighting in different scenarios in order to be widely used. One common technique for creating these avatars is through the use of monocular films, which allows for movement and realistic image quality. But the synthesized images are limited by the lighting conditions in the training video. Other methods for relighting human avatars have been proposed, but they do not allow the user to control the body's pose and often require the use of multi-view photos taken in a controlled environment using a light stage for training. Now, with NVIDIA's relightable articulated neural avatar technique called RANA, the above-mentioned problems are solved by creating photorealistic human animations in any body posture, perspective, and lighting scenario. This technique simulates the complex articulations and physical characteristics of the human body in order to achieve this level of realism. Another recent breakthrough from Stanford called Point Avatar is an artificial intelligence that can create 3D head avatars from videos. The ability to create realistic, animated, and relatable head avatars from casual video sequences would have many applications in communication and entertainment. Current methods either use explicit 3D morphable meshes, known as 3DMM, or neural implicit representations. The former are limited by fixed topology, while the latter are difficult to deform and inefficient to render. Additionally, existing approaches combine lighting and color estimation, limiting their ability to re-render the avatar in different environments. In contrast, the artificial intelligence researchers from ETH Zurich, Max Planck Institute for Intelligent Systems, and Stanford University have proposed Point Avatar, a deformable point-based representation that separates the source color into intrinsic albedo and normal-dependent shading. Point Avatar combines high-quality geometry and appearance with topological flexibility, ease of deformation, and rendering efficiency to bridge the gap between mesh and implicit representations. This method is able to generate realistic 3D avatars using monocular videos from various sources, including handheld smartphones, laptop webcams, and internet videos, achieving state-of-the-art quality in challenging cases where previous methods fail, while being significantly more efficient in terms of training when compared with other methods.